It's nice to see you all after a long time. First of all, let me congratulate you for being promoted to Class A. In Class A, I am Purushottam. As usual, I will be teaching you social science. You know that in social science we have two subjects. First one is history, second one is geography. Let's start our session with history. In Class 8 history, we see modern India. You know that historians have categorized history into three divisions. In Class 6, we have seen first division of history, that is ancient period, which is also called as Vedic period. In that period, the society was governed by various laws given in the Vedas. The second category, second division of history is medieval period. We start from 8th century to mid 18th century. Now in class 7, we have seen medieval period. At the medieval period, we have seen various regional powers like Chelas, Cholas, Pandyas. After the invasion of Muhammad Ghazni, in Latin medieval period, we have seen that Arabs and Persians established their rule in India in the form of Delhi Sultanate and later in the form of Mughal Empire. After the death of Aurangzeb, as there was no potent king in central administration, there was a kind of chaos in the Indian society that led to the emergence of various regional powers like Nawabs of Awadh, Bengal, Marathas and Rajput in Punjab. These regional powers administrated in the particular region that also led to the situation where foreign traders would establish themselves in India and form their policies. In Class 8, we mainly focus on the modern time, how those traders came in India, established themselves and how they ruled over India. So in Class 8 is all about the modern age, and I will bring you a sense of patriotism in Class 8, because in Class 8 itself we will see the Indian struggle. So Class 8 starts with the traces of modern history. After that, beginning of colonization in India, how those Europeans colonized in India and how they formed various policies like agrarian policies, education policies, and then great uprising of 1857 against the British government, finally leading towards the building of strong nation. In series also, we will be focusing mainly on the Indian constitution, which is a law of the land that gives us rights and duties, that also gives directive principles for the government, for the state. So all that is all about the modern India. So in Class 8, we will mostly focus on the modern age. How all that began? The British rule in India for last two centuries of Indian history started with the beginning of the formation of this company, that is British East India. Now this portrait shows you cold room of British East India Company around in the 18th century. Now, as India was called as Golden Sparrow, because of huge revenue generated in India, India was a house of spices. Fine quality of silk was produced in India. Cotton was valued in international market. So these valued commodities attracted many traders in India. Among them, the first trader that arrived in India through sea route was Vasco da Gama. Vasco da Gama in 1498 stepped on a Calicut beach, Calicut port of India, where from Zonarin he got the rights of trading in that port, and he earned a lot from that particular expedition towards India, and that laid the foundation of trade through a water route, through the ocean route. So Vasco da Gama basically is valued for his discovery to India through a ocean route. Later on, after Vasco da Gama, many countries visited in India for the trade. Now, British East India Company was formed by Carter, Royal Carter, on December 31st, 1600. The company was formed so that it can act as monopolistic trading body in India. Now, what happened back then? Companies used to eliminate the competition among the countrymen. So, each country used to form one company which is dedicated for trading purpose in the particular land, the given land, so that there will be no competition among the various companies from the same country. To trade in India, the English people, Britishers, formed a company which is known as the British East India Company, so that one country only can trade with India from the British citizens. Such type of companies were formed by different countries also. So we had Dutch East India Company, we had Portuguese East India Company, and all those who come to the India for trading purpose, because the trading in India of spices, Indian spices, was very huge. So British East India Company was formed that it could participate in Indian spice trade, because that was the most valuable commodity in the international market, along with the indigo, along with the fine silk, along with the cotton. So that could also trade, British East India Company could also trade in cotton, silk, indigo, tea, and it can also be useful for transport of slaves. Back then, slavery was not an offense. So this is the trade route through ocean. Here you can see, starting from Europe, going around the African continent, taking turn from Cape of Good Hope and arriving in India. Basically, this trade route has led new avenues for European country to trade in India, to get highly profitable material like spices, indigo, silk. So from 1600 to 1630, British East India people, traders, came to India, traded with them. But on the western side, in 1630, Jahangir issued a permitting England to establish a permanent factory in Surat. So due to this permit, England could gain a land in India, could erect a factory, could get a permanent settlement in India. Now, to mind you, the first English factory was established in Masulipatnam of Andhra coast of Bay of Bengal back in 1611. Up in 1619, British already had factories at Surat, at Ahmedabad, at Bharuch, at Agra. So now they could have the permanent settlements in the form of Indian factories, and this marriage between Charles II of England and Catherine of Braganza has also played its part in shaping our history, because on 21st of May 1662, marriage treaty was signed, in which Bombay was handed over to British Empire in the form of dowry. So, in this alliance of marriage, the Bombay, which was basically seven islands, were given to the Charles II of England in the form of dowry. Now, Charles II rented those islands to the British East India Company on the annual rate of £10. That's how the English British East India Company gave an important port on sea known as Bombay. So that's it for today. Till now we have seen that British East India Company arrived in India, erected their factory as part of the permanent land, and in next period we'll see how those traders become masters, how those traders could take part in Indian politics and influence the Indian history. If you have any doubt, feel free to comment. And till then, bye. Thank you.